Now, the former coach of the Socceroos, Terry Venables, has died aged 80. His family says he died peacefully on Saturday after a long illness. Venables coached Australia during the World Cup qualifiers in 1997. A year earlier, he led England to the semi-finals of the European Championship. The great Ange Postecoglou has called Venables the best coach, manager and tactician he has ever come across. Tottenham and Aston Villa held a minute's silence before their game at the weekend, with both teams wearing black armbands. One man who knew Terry Venables very well was former Socceroos Craig Foster. He joins us now. Hello, Craig. He was your coach for a while with the Socceroos. Tell us about him.
Yeah, thanks, Hugh. It's a sad day for, I think, all of Australian football, particularly those who played under him. You've seen some legendary names, particularly in England, you know, Alan Shearer and Gary Lineker and others, you know, really effusive in their praise. The players loved Terry. He was a huge personality and he generally loved the players. But I think more importantly in Australia, he changed our game here. He was only here for about 12 months. And as you saw in your story there, we weren't able to get through that 1997 qualification series against Iran. It was 1-1 away in Tehran. You can see a very young Harry Kewell there was in the team, Mark Viduka, Mark Bosnich, you know, a legendary, great generation. Sadly, we failed in that 2-2 infamous game against Iran in Melbourne. Nevertheless, throughout that period, he took the national team for the first time. We'd never been in the top 50 in the world. We were down, well, we were up to 30 in the world under Terry. Played fabulous football, and it was the first time he really opened the eyes of certainly the players, the local domestic coaches, and you heard, you know, glowing words from Ange Postecoglou there, who, of course, is now a Tottenham coach where Terry had coached previously. So he brought a new system of play, brought a new belief in being able to play in a really proactive, attacking manner in Australia, and he changed the minds of many, many people, including me, and so he's had a huge legacy and impact on the game here.
How did he change your game?
Well, I found playing under Terry really straightforward, and that he was able to, I was one of those players, I was able to understand the system well. And so when he came in, the first couple of training sessions were so very, very different to what we were used to here in Australia, despite the fact that the vast majority of that golden generation, as it was at the time, were playing in some of the biggest leagues under the world and had been in, you know, top under top-class coaches. But he was our first marquee coach signing, I would say, for a foreigner to come in. David Heal, who was the chair at the time, you know, was a courageous move. With the advice of the great Craig Johnston, of course, the Liverpool legend who knew Terry and said, look, we need someone who's at the highest level. Are you looking here at, you know, when we were 2-0 up against Iran and sadly someone ran out of the crowd and stopped the game by jumping on the goal, and that changed the momentum. And following that, the Iranians were able to score a couple of goals, 2-2 in the end, and we went out on away goals. So it's not nice vision for those of us who played under Terry in that time. But just only a little later that month, we went over to the Confederations Cup abroad, the first ever. We beat Mexico, beat Uruguay. And the team's record under him was exceptionally good. Again, though, what he did was he brought us a system of play, a kind of a way of thinking about the game that he'd learnt at Barcelona. I was his captain at Crystal Palace. And I later asked him, I said, look, you didn't learn that, you know, across in England. You know, where did this come from? And he said, look, when I got to FC Barcelona in 85, he won the La Liga, first time in 11 years for Barca. And he said, I just stood there. I watched for a few months. I learned their system of play. And that's what he brought to Australia. So he changed our way of thinking. He changed ultimately the evolution of Australian football in a really profound way. And today our coaches have progressed precisely along the lines that we were hoping for. And that is in the footsteps of Terry, or understanding the game in a very different way and being able to bring it to life.
He's such a coaching identity. People forget that he was a pretty handy player too. He played for England. But, you know, we're hearing a lot of greats of the game. Ange Postecoglou, you mentioned. Alan Shearer, you mentioned also. Both of them have spoken about his tactical awareness, having a unique ability to kind of read the tactics. What does that actually mean on a football field in a tough game, to have that sort of insight in your back, up on your bench, I guess?
Well, you know, opinions are split as to the Iran game. So, you know, his legacy in terms of the Socceroos is mixed, of course, because we didn't make it through, despite the extraordinary talent that we had in that team. And, you know, there's a feeling in Australian football that had we made France 98, you know, only 8 months later, that team could have really done something in the tournament. So we look back wistfully at that part of, you know, his his coaching experience and ours as players under him. But what he did do, Hugh, was this. Prior to, the players were very much relied on to bring the game to life. And, you know, we were a part-time football ecosystem here in Australia in the 90s and prior, and therefore that's completely understandable. You know, our coaches were still working in other jobs at the same time as they were trying to thrive and learn the game. And what Terry did for the first time was connected us into the international arena of technical thought, if you like. I said he was a marquee coach, so he was working with FIFA at the time, along with Pele and Beckenbauer and Johan Cruyff, you know, one of the most famous names in terms of thinking and conceptualizing the game. And they were on the FIFA global kind of thought panel. And here he was in charge of Australia. He took his first couple of sessions. And afterwards, I remember being in the hotel with some legendary Australian football playing names, and everyone agreed that it was very different what we'd seen, that we're incredibly impressed, and that this was a completely new level. So he opened our eyes as players. You know, many of those people who either played under him or had watched have now gone on to, you know, outstanding coaching careers, including Graham Arnold, who was just coming to the end of his career and still had the opportunity to see Terry coaching. But more than that, for those of us who went on into broadcast, what it did was change our minds as to what Australian football needed to do. We'd seen this level. We saw what was happening here in Australia as well. And despite the immense talent that we have, of course, across all sport, we didn't have the methodology. We lacked the education. And so, you know, playing under him was part of, I think, a broader commitment of that generation of players to say, we need to be better. We need to grow. And we want our Australian coaches to coach like that. And here we are today in a position where, you know, we've got, we've got Ange at Tottenham, of course, and we've got a coach, Joe Montemuro, coaching Juventus women. We've got Kevin Mascot doing well across in Japan. And, of course, Graham Arnold did brilliantly last year in the Qatar World Cup.
Indeed. Great insights, a great character, missed here and very much missed in the UK as well. Craig Foster, yeah. Thank you.